This time of year is a critical one for charities and nonprofits that rely on a surge of holiday giving to make ends meet. But this year, we've seen the need for their services dramatically grow, especially at food banks, where lines are stretching longer than before. For more on the state of giving in America, I'm joined by Stacey Palmer. She's the editor of the Chronicle of Philanthropy. Stacey Palmer, welcome back to the NewsHour. I think it's fair to say the pandemic has had devastating economic impact on the country, and philanthropies are no exception. In fact, one analysis looked at over 300,000 U.S.-based nonprofits, and it found that in the most dire scenario, nearly 120,000 of them could close. How badly has the pandemic hurt philanthropy?
Philanthropy itself is fairly strong. People are giving generously, but that's not enough to help nonprofits. And so you're right. Many nonprofits are worried about closing. They've laid off their employees. They can't keep up with the demand for services. So it's a really rough time in the nonprofit world, no matter how generous Americans have been.
And is there a difference between how larger groups versus smaller groups have fared during this time?
Groups of all sizes are struggling, but it's those small and mid-sized groups that we count on in many communities. They barely have any reserves. Some of them have 1 to 2 weeks of reserves. So when that financial cushion runs out, you know, their only choice is to cut back services, lay off workers, or that kind of thing. So it's a very scary situation for many nonprofits.
We've also seen during the pandemic inequality in America also grow dramatically, and millions of Americans are struggling with lost wages and jobs, but the country's richest, over 600 billionaires, added almost $1 trillion in total net worth during the pandemic. Has that fueled any additional giving from the richest Americans?
We have seen some amazing gifts from some of the very wealthiest people. Mackenzie Scott, the former wife of Jeff Bezos, has given $6 billion this year. So it's an amazing thing. Jack Dorsey of Twitter has given very generously. So we're seeing those amazing gifts. But even still, it's not enough to make up for the losses that nonprofits have. And nonprofits depend on government just like a lot of us do. So it's not just philanthropy. But the reason they're suffering is because they get their money in so many different ways. And they're not available anymore.
Stacey, the need is so great right now, but that need will extend far beyond the holidays when people are more likely to give. For folks out there who are struggling, trying to prioritize where and how to give, what would your advice be?
Almost every nonprofit needs money now, so you should make the choice of what you care about most in your community. Those of us who are getting stimulus checks, maybe don't need them, have a little bit of extra money. It's a great thing for us to try to give to the people in our communities who are suffering the most. But think about other causes, mental health groups, arts groups, other kinds of groups that we don't think about with those food bank lines. They also need your help, so they'll appreciate anything that you can give.
And we know that need will be there for many weeks and months to come. That is Stacey Palmer from the Chronicle of Philanthropy. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you so much.